Logic TV.
Lolly, 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 get your adverbs here. Lolly, 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 got some adverbs here.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. I am the esteemed Reverend Adam Utopia here from Pure Logic TV. Now, I've been doing this internet broadcast for a while now, and y'all seem to really enjoy it. Well, some of y'all do. And people have been sending me questions, philosophical type questions, questions about nature and the earth and the good Lord and what they think that I think about things. You know what I'm saying? And I've read through some of these questions, and some of them are downright mean. I ain't going to lie to you. There's been a couple times that y'all threatened to kill me. I ain't going down, you dirty bitch. I ain't going down at all. But the thing is that this young lady, and I don't know quite what her name is. This is forwarded to me by the good people of Pure Logic TV. God damn it. The good people at Pure Logic TV, they sent me this, and it's I think the young lady's name's Michelle. I'm not quite sure. So now, her questions read as follows. Number one, now there's a lot of questions. I don't know if I can answer them in the 10 minutes.
Y'all settle down out there, goddammit! I'm doing the internet.
Sorry about that, y'all. I didn't mean to use the good Lord's name in vain, but sometimes you got to use the good Lord's name to get people's attention. You know what I'm saying? Especially if you follow it with the word damn. Remember that. There's too many questions on this piece of paper right here. Now, I know that they expect me to do this and this, that, and the other, but I figured what I'd do is I wrote all the questions down from this young lady. There's like 30-some questions here, all right? It reads kind of like one of the Mensa applications. I took one of them. I'm not a member yet. That test pretty hard.
Y'all feel bad out there, goddammit, I'm doing the internet.
Excuse me one second.
If I have to come out here one more time, I'm gonna kick that ass. Now you get in there to your room right now and go finish your homework. I don't care if your mama told you to vacuum, you son of a bitch.
Sorry, I got my brother's kids over. We bring them over to house clean about 3 times a month. Little bastards to clean the whole damn house for $5. I hate it when they gonna turn 8, cause once they get about 8, 9 years old, they figure out what money is, and they figure that ain't gonna be enough. And man, them 5-year-old kids can scrub a toilet, you know what I'm saying? So anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and answer all of the questions right now. Instead of reading you the questions off, and instead of going through this big old giant spill, I wrote down the answers. I answered every damn question, alright? You ready? Alright, because the cat was curious, no, it's still in a coma with 35% chance of losing its left paw. Grass doesn't limit its potential. 3 chords, no, not a war. How's that relevant towards your salvation? Yes, but Billy Corgan never did. If I was wrapped in a dance, in a douche, I'd fall to the ground. Led Zeppelin is a devil. Yes, every inch of his love. Every inch. Huh? No, singing about Satan. What does Led Zeppelin have to do with your salvation? That's answer number 12. I'm not going to answer number 13 because that's kind of personal. Number 14, yes, women. Number 15, enough to fill women with. You know what I'm saying? That's right. Number 16 is what self-respecting white person don't have a garage in their yard? Number 17, women. Yes, women. 9 7/4 rounded to the nearest parsec. 3, you dirty bitch. If I speak a sermon and no one hears it, are you still my bitch? Best party time. Just a slob like one of us. 3:47, but don't hold me to that now. Do you really think that being gay is a choice? Who? Yes, they are life partners. Wait, I don't even know why I'm going through all of this. I mean, hell, if you're going to send me a question, all right? Send me one damn question, all right? Because I ain't got time to answer 15, 20, 37 questions. 8. Now, there's a lot of questions here, all right? Now, I answered every single one of them. And the person that sent me these, they're going to get a copy of every answer I got corresponding with the questions. That's the way they like it, huh? I ain't got no secretary, all right? I ain't got no operating budget. The ZenKill Ministries is founded for the pure reason. Hey, right, there's somebody at the door. Answer that damn door now. God. The problem is, ladies and gentlemen, is I ain't making no money off this enterprise. Now, we've discussed this before, but I'm going to tell you right now. Hey, is that the man? Is that the man with stuff? Excuse me one second, ladies and gentlemen.
Certified letter.
Hell, send that thing back. Don't you sign nothing. Don't you sign nothing, you bitch. God. And you tell them not, they're trespassing on our property. The mailbox is out there by the road. God damn it.
Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. People trying to, they trying to do bad things to me. You know, I got to thinking about it. One of the questions is, in this little thing right here, what is the matrix? Alright? I'm going to tell you what the matrix is, ladies and gentlemen. Your social security number, your driver's license number, your car tag number, your telephone number, how old you is, how old your wife is, how old them kids that you ain't told nobody about that you got is. Huh? It's all out there. It's on the matrix, on the internet. The internet is evil, and I'm here to tell you that right now. Huh? Now, I know it sounds a little far-fetched, but hell, I got a broadcast on the internet. They won't let me on TV after that whole FCC thing. Now, I'm not allowed to talk about that either. Hell yeah. That's the power of lawyers, ladies and gentlemen. If you got yourself a lawyer, you can buy your way out of just about anything. But if you ever bought a lawyer before, them motherfuckers are expensive. They almost as expensive as a judge or a cop. That's real nice. Ladies and gentlemen, this week I've decided to sample some cerveza. They call this cerveza down south of the border. It's real nice. It really is. It's a little better with lime. I don't know why. I think it's because it's something about sanitation and whatnot. That Mexican water, you ain't supposed to drink it. Now, I ain't never been as far south as Mexico. Hell, I ain't been far south as Alabama.
What? Hey, take that thing out of the oven. Don't be touching on that now. I'm drying that out for the neighbors. They didn't bought all of it.
I didn't get no mushrooms, and I don't know why you keep bringing it up. But anyways, it's important to sanitize the Mexican beer. Now, I love them wetbacks. As we've discussed before, they can lay some drywall and they can lay some concrete. And they make some pretty damn good beer. But I'm here to tell you right now, their water, they don't know how to sanitize the water. How many Mexican plumbers you know? Huh? I'm not saying they ain't out there. How many Mexican plumbers you know? Huh? Andale. Fix the pipes. Well, I don't, you know. What else you want me to say, ladies and gentlemen? My ministry is going to flounder. Huh? The good Lord is going to strike me down. Huh? Do you want to see me get struck down? Huh? Do you? Don't answer that question. You know you don't. You know that the good Lord needs your money to give to me to be able to do His work for you. Huh? That's a beautiful thing right there. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that ends this Pure Logic episode. My name is the esteemed Reverend Adam Utopia. And I think that's about all I got to say. And you Mexican people, I like your beer.
My family away from my Carolina home had dreams about